In this video, we are going to see about the music's instrument and their sounds.
Which is the first song in Bible, which is the covenant song? What were the instrument in the olden days?
Which is God's favorite instrument?
How did the earlier kings in Bible worship the Lord?
How did Abijah, the king of Judah, got victory in the battle?
Come, let's go to the video.
Shout and be glad, daughter of Zion, for I am coming and live among you, declares the Lord. Sing, barren woman, you who never bore a child, burst into song. More are the children of the desolate woman than of her who has a husband, says the Lord. Come, let us sing for joy to the Lord. Let us shout to rock of our salvation. Sing to the Lord new song, for he has done marvelous things. Praise him with the sounding of the trumpet. Praise him with the harp and lyre. Praise him with timbre and dancing. Praise him with the strings and pipe. Make music to the Lord with the harp and the sound of singing. Then Moses and Israelites sang this song to the Lord. I will sing to the Lord, for he is highly exalted. The Lord said to Moses, write down a song for yourselves and teach it to the children of Israel. Put it in their mouths that this song may be a witness for me against the children of Israel. Then Miriam the prophetess took the timbre in their hand, and all the women went out after her with timbres and with dances. Then Miriam said, sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. The Lord said to Moses, gather the people together and I will give them water. Then Israel sang this song, spring up, O well, sing about it. The Lord said to Moses, make two trumpets of hammer silver. When you go into a battle against an enemy, sound a blast on the trumpets. Then you will be remembered by the Lord your God and rescued from enemies. Also at your times of rejoicing, appointed festivals, new moon feast. You are to sound the trumpets, and they will be memorial for your before your God. The song of Deborah is victory hymn, sung by Deborah and Barak, about the defeat of Canaanite's adversaries by some of the tribes of Israel. You strum away on your harps like David, and improvise on musical instruments, speaking to one another with psalms, hymns, and songs from the Spirit. Sing and make music from your heart to the Lord. When the trumpet sounded, the army shouted, and at the sound of the trumpet, when the men gave a loud shout, the wall collapsed. So everyone charged straight in and they took the city. David appointed some of the Levites to minister before the ark of the Lord to extol, thank, and praise the Lord of Israel. Asaph was the chief. They were to play the lyres, harps. Asaph was to sound the cymbals. And the priests were to blow the trumpets regularly before the ark of the covenant of God. The Levites, all who were skilled in playing musical instruments. Those who were musicians, heads of Levite families, stayed in the rooms of the temple and were exempt from other duties, because they are responsible for the work day and night. The 12 tribes are earnestly serve God day and night. The sound of the horn, flute, zither, lyre, harp, pipe, and and all kinds of music in olden days. Solomon is credited with 1005 songs, but Songs of Solomon stands high above the rest. Levites who were the singers, clothed in fine linen, having cymbals, stringed instruments, and harps, and with them 120 priests sounding with trumpets. The trumpeters and singers lifted up their voice with the instruments of music and praised the Lord, saying, "For He is good, for His mercy endures forever." That the house of the Lord was filled with the glory. And the priests could not perform their service because of the cloud. For the glory of the Lord filled the house of God. Then Solomon said, "The Lord has said that He would dwell in a dark cloud." The servants of Hiram and Solomon brought algum wood from Ophir. The king used the algum wood to make harps and lyres for the musicians. Nothing like them had ever been seen in Judah. The people of Judah cried out to the Lord. The priests blew their trumpets and men of Judah shouted. The Lord gave victory to the king of Judah. Levites stood up to praise the God of Israel with voices loud and high. So when they go to battle, they put on the front lines not soldiers, but the singers, and the singers cried out. Now when they began to sing and to praise, the Lord gave victory to the king Jehoshaphat. Children of Israel kept the Passover for 7 days with great gladness. The Levites and the priests praised the Lord day by day, singing to the Lord, accompanied by loud instruments. The priests in their vestments and with trumpets, the Levites with cymbals praised the Lord, as prescribed by David, king of Israel, with praise and thanksgiving. They sang to the Lord, "He is good, His love towards Israel endures forever." Many of the older priests and Levites and family heads wept aloud when they saw the foundation of the temple being laid, while many others shouted for joy. The musicians were brought together around Jerusalem, for the musicians built villages for themselves around Jerusalem. For long ago, the days of David and Asaph, there had been directors for the musicians and for the songs of praise and thanksgiving to God. So in the days of Nehemiah, all Israel contributed the daily portions for the musicians. Elisha said to the kings, "Bring me a harpist," and while the harpist was playing, the hand of God came on Elisha. The Lord says, "From Jacob's tent will come songs of thanksgiving. I will add to their numbers, and they will not be decreased." He says, "I will declare your name to my brothers and sisters in the assembly. I will sing your praises." Jesus and apostles sing him in the upper room after Christ's Last Supper. Paul and Silas sing him when they were in prison, then God breaks them out. I will sing with my spirit, but I will also sing with my understanding. Jesus, the Lion of Judah, the root of David, he went and took the scroll from the throne. The four living creatures and the 24 elders fell down before the Lamb. Each one had a harp and they sang a new song. Is anyone among you happy? Let them sing songs of praise. You teach and admonish one another with all wisdom, through psalms, hymns, and songs from the Spirit, singing to God with gratitude in your hearts. The richness of the King Solomon.